The state's economy is struggling during the pandemic, but one group is hoping it to help bounce back on its road to recovery.
Rob Nobriga, Economy Changes Committee Chair for the Hawaii Executive Collaborative, joins us live tonight. Rob, thanks so much for joining us.
Aloha, Mika and Brenton. Thank you for having me tonight.
So I know that there's been a roadmap created, and from what I take from it, the goal is to really help residents prepare and get jobs back and really to jumpstart the economy. So tell us a little bit about what this roadmap is.
Really, if I were to boil it down, it's an opportunity to invest in our people to help jumpstart the economy. The roadmap basically lays out a plan to spur economic recovery by providing these pathways for economic advancement for Hawaii's residents. And at its core, it's really about ensuring that there are qualified Hawaii applicants for all job openings. And we think that, you know, to help build a sustainable economy, the roadmap needs to prioritize certain sectors that offer resilient, recession-resilient, and high-wage, in-demand jobs right now. And these are essentially what we'd see as low-hanging fruit. And three of these sectors are healthcare, including both clinical and community health career pathways, technology, including IT, biotech, and emerging clean energy occupations, and skilled trades in sustainable agriculture, construction, and manufacturing. But in order to do this, we have to close the skill gap in Hawaii. And to close the skill gap, we need to build career pathways. And there are three things that really need to focus on in order to do this. We need to expand work-based learning programs that give students as well as adult learners the experience and credentials they need to pursue in-demand jobs in Hawaii. We also got to rapidly reskill the population by making sure we're investing in the right programs, especially for community colleges that can fast-track students into the job market. And we got to focus on the right sectors so that those employers that need more skilled workers we're connecting them to education and training programs that are designed to provide them with those skilled workers.
Rob, it's a detailed plan. Right now, how feasible is it? Do you think it's possible for something like this to happen? Let's say a lot of people are out of job in tourism. They got to get reskilled. If they don't get their job back, and maybe perhaps go into one of these branches that you shared, but how possible is it to be able to get that help to reskill yourself in such a short period of time with all this pandemic crisis going on?
That's a great question. I mean, it's not easy, but there are examples of community organizations that are doing a real good job. And I'll just throw out Kupu, you know, under John Leong's leadership, that is doing a phenomenal job of creating opportunities to provide sustainable and sustainability type jobs that are available right now. So, and in healthcare, there's also great examples. Hawaii Pacific Health has done a good job, you know, working on medical technician positions. It's not easy, but you know, we got to try. And there's funding available. Part of this plan is to make sure that the funding is investing in the right sectors and the right places.
Rob Nobriga, thank you so much for stopping by tonight. We appreciate your time.
Thank you for having me.
Thanks, Aloha. Rob.